Hi dear friends, how are you? I'm Vikas from Vikas Driving School. Today I have Narisa with me. She passed her driving test in third attempt. She gave a test in it before that as well, but she couldn't pass her driving test. So today Narisa is with me. So she going to tell us about what mistake she done in the first attempt and what mistake she did in second attempt. And the third mistake, what how she passed and what mistake she has done in third test. So Narisa, you give your test in two time. The first test, what happened? What mistake you did in the first?
Yeah, so my first mistake, for the first attempt, I let the pedestrian cross where he's not supposed to cross, and I stopped the car, and then there's a car behind me.
Okay.
So I make like the road congested.
Immediate fail
for the first
because
time
because you're distracting other road users. So the first point Narisa is here, she just start to give way to the pedestrian because there was no pedestrian crossing. So make sure, my dear friend, if there is no pedestrian crossing, you don't need to give way to anyone. If somebody standing left and right hand side, you can go, and if somebody just came just front of our car, then we cannot run away. So we need to stop and we need to give way to them. But if somebody standing left and right, we don't need to give way, we don't need to worry, we just need to be extra careful, so make sure they will not come on our way, but we don't need to stop our car. And that's all you did in the first attempt?
That's the immediate fail.
Okay. And do you have bit practice before the when you give your first driving test? Have you done any practice?
I have like 2 hours of practice around the area.
Around the before the test.
Yeah.
So that's all you had, just 2 hour lesson in Australia.
Yeah.
Okay. And before that, you from Thailand, yeah?
Yeah.
So you used to drive in Thailand?
Yeah, I used to drive in Thailand for almost five to six years.
Yeah. Oh, that's very good. That means you have a very good experience, my dear friend. As you can see, the experienced driver as well, they can fail their driving test. If you don't know about the road law, rule and regulation, about the driving test criteria, so make sure you must need to study well before going to driving test, and you must need to know about the driving test procedure, about the road law, if you want to pass your driving test. What about the second step?
So the second attempt, it was raining heavily, and I got really nervous because of the first time that I failed. I hit the curb at the roundabout, so collision, that's the immediate fail as well.
Okay.
Yeah.
So how much you hit? You just hit a little bit?
Yeah, just a little bit.
Little bit they fail?
Yeah, in carton.
Maybe you hit a little very hard.
I didn't go like
if you touch a little bit, it's when especially you did in 3-point turn or reverse parallel, when did you hit that curb?
When I go into the roundabout.
Okay.
I hit the curb at the left side.
I got it. In a 3-point turn and reverse parallel parking, you can touch the curbs when you're going forward and the backward. That is allowed. But after that, if anywhere you're going to touch your curb anywhere, you're going to hit curb anywhere, that is immediate termination. So that's why they fail you.
Yes,
that is very big mistake. Make sure, my dear friend, when you're driving your car, never hit the curb. Be extra careful. So especially students, they fail their driving test when they turn left. They start to turn little bit early. When they start to turn little bit early, they touch that curb. Because of that little mistake, if you're going to fix it, you will not fail your driving test. And what about today she passed driving test with me, and today what he mentioned about your driving?
So on the 80 kilometers limit sign, on that road, I was nervous that I will go over the limit. So I drive a little bit slow, and I drive about exactly 70. The examiner said if I go a little bit lower than 70, then I might fail.
So she drive a little bit slow on the 80 zone, like 80 zone. It's not all the time. We drive just very short distance. But if we're going to drive all the way, then they can fail us to driving too slow. But if you're going to drive for a little time, that is fine, but not too slow as well. As she was driving on 70, he gave us critical error. As you know, in the driving test, there are mistakes are allowed as well. There is a two critical error, means two big mistakes are allowed. So she just do little slow. So he gave us a critical error. So do you give any message to my student? Because you have a very good experience about the driving test now. This is your third attempt. So you know about you, two time you give driving test in a Carlton, yeah? How you feel about the Carlton? And today she is with me in the Kullu area. So how do you feel is the Kullu area and the Carlton area?
In my opinion, in Carlton, if you are familiar with Carlton area, I think it's okay to go to have the test there. But if you're not really familiar, then I think Kullu might be a better choice, because the road is bigger, there's less stop signs. I think with your nerve as well, I think Kullu is easier. In my opinion.
So you're recommending to students the better to give your driving test somewhere a little bit quieter. So do you want to give any another tips?
Just don't be nervous, have enough sleep, watch a lot of Vikas videos.
Is it my video really help you to pass your driving test?
When I failed two times, and I felt really bad about myself. So I don't even want to do it again.
Oh really? Actually, that much bad you
feel? And then I start I don't give up, then I start watching your video first, and then I contact you, because I think you give like really good advice. So I'm here with him in Kullu and pass on my first attempt.
So thank you so much, my dear friend. So please guys, if you haven't subscribed my channel, please subscribe my channel, because I'm going to add more value, more tips and tricks to pass your driving test first go. So bye for now.